Hi, I'm Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. In my last tutorial, we looked at the vector scope and how it works in relation to colour and the colour wheel. Today though, we're going to look at this guy here, and this is the waveform. Let me explain to you how the waveforms actually work. But first, we need to make some changes to the video scope. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to tap on the little arrow here and I'm going to change to waveform. So we've got a second waveform, but this waveform is the YCbCr color space. More about that in a little while. Then I'm going to move over to the central waveform and you can see it's set up as waveform, RGB, and I've got red, green and blue selected. In this one I'm going to switch off red and I'm going to switch off green. That way we can focus on the blue because of the yellow in the actual sunrise, and obviously blue is the opposite of yellow in the color wheel. And then finally I'm going to change this last one to just a normal waveform whereby it's RGB and all three colors are represented, red, green and blue. Now we can see three different types of waveform, and as you learn about them you can decide which waveform suits you the best. Okay, let's scale things up and take a closer look at the waveforms. The lower third of the graph represents the shadow area, and the middle third represents the mid-tone area, and finally the upper third represents the highlights. And obviously all of these are adjustable depending on what settings you apply using the control sliders on the right hand side. The left to right portion of the graph represents the pixels as they are displayed throughout the moving video, and you can see that in this example. Note you can see the stars and stripes rippling effect working its way through the actual graph from right to left. And then if we go back to the sunrise, you can see the pixels rising up in the blue only waveform. As we discussed in explaining vector scopes video, RGB is a color space that uses red, green and blue components that make up the primary colors of the color wheel. Using these three components, any color can pretty much be displayed. So what in the Scooby Snacks is YCbCr? Well, YCbCr is also another color space, but different spaces are taken up. Well, let me explain. In this space, the Y is the Luma component of the color. Luma equals the brightness of the color, or how intense the color gets. FYI, the human eye is more sensitive to this component, and that's why when you're creating an image, you should always have the focal point to be a brighter color than anything else. This can be done in camera or in post. Now the CB and the CR components of the color space are CB stands for the blue component and CR stands for the red component. You can ignore all this because at the end of the day, the human eye is much more sensitive to the brightness of the color than it is to the CB or the CR. Therefore, in this particular color space, you'll see just a white graph, and that represents the majority of the Y, and you can use that to work out and focus on specific luminance or brightness of the color more than anything else. If you're really not confident in using the YCbCr color space, then just stick to RGB. Okay, so I've got this close-up of a female's left eye, and what we're going to do is just press number 5 on the keyboard to bring up color and effects, tap on original, that gives us our basic controls, and then we can look at the different scopes. What I'm going to do is just set everything back the way I would normally have it, and this would be the waveform with red, green and blue on. There we go, and then I would have this as the vector scope. So this is the normal kind of layout I work with, and what I would tend to do is just find a good point to grade, probably actually with the eye closed so I can see the eyelid, and then we'll check it when it's actually open. And then all you're going to do is look at the waveform itself. You can see it's a very bright image. There's a lot of information at the top end. And if we play the video through, you can see the changes, the pixels. So we'll probably go here. And what we're then going to do is just take everything down. So I can, of course, go into my highlight amount and reduce the highlights and see how that brings it down at the top here. And you can decide how much or how little you want to do that. And then, do we need to open things up in the shadows? I don't think so. Do we need to crush the shadows a little bit? You'll notice that stretches out the waveform ever so slightly. And then we can go back up to likes of contrast. And you can see contrast will either compress things if you make it flatter, or the more contrasty you create, the more spread out the pixels will be. I think I'm okay with that. Let's see if we can reduce the brightness and note how that brings down, just get that quite subtle, the pixel information. And then finally, if we want to, we can play with the gamma a little bit. And if we just move forward, we can see where we're at. If we scroll up to the top, there's before and there's after. I'll just let that run through. Before, after. I think I'll actually increase the brightness again. And just play with the levels ever so slightly. There. Let it run. Before, after. And I can obviously use the vectorscope to check my colors. Make sure the skin tones information is along the skin tone line. And we also have our histograms here, which we will talk about in the next video tutorial. So there you go. That's a basic example of how color grading works using the waveform dialog here within the video scopes. If you've enjoyed the video, by all means give it a thumbs up. If I've earned your subscription, subscribe to the channel and don't forget to ring the bell, and that will let you know when the next video tutorial has been uploaded. I'm Stu, and I will catch you on the next one. See you later.